Greetings, Eric Bakker, naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for coming back. I often get asked by people about histamine reactions, you know, about feeling sick or flushed in the face or nauseous and brain fog. And many people think that they've got a problem with a histamine reaction. In fact, they could have a reaction with sulfur in their body. So sulfur is quite a natural compound found in a whole bunch of different foods. It's found especially in foods like garlic and onions. It's found in brassicas. You found it a lot in cauliflower, broccoli. You can even find it in watermelon. A quick Google search will show you a whole list of sulfur-containing foods. Eggs, for example, contain a lot of sulfur in them. Some people know that they react to these foods. Other people don't. So if we look at the structure of amino acids, or if you look at amino acids, protein break down to building blocks. We've got carbohydrates, we've got proteins, we've got fats. But if we look at proteins and break them down, we've got 21 different amino acids. Now, two of these amino acids contain sulfur, methionine and cysteine, right? So if we try and understand this, we're going to go a little bit into chemistry here to explain biochemistry, to explain a few things to you. So sulfur is very important for the body, particularly for detoxification, because methionine and cysteine drive three main detoxification pathways in your liver. Your liver has two main ways how it breaks foods down to detoxify, like two filtration stages, phase one and phase two. Phase one works by virtue of a whole bunch of different enzyme systems called P450 enzymes. Phase two works with five different regulatory systems, five different pathways, how it breaks foods down. So it breaks toxins down. So three of those pathways rely on methionine and cysteine to really help to drive them properly. So let's just have a look at those three systems here. I wonder if you can see my chart here. So here we've got phase one and phase two. Sulfation, glucuronidation, and glutathione S-transferase. So those three pathways rely on cysteine and methionine. So they plug into that system. So if you've got a problem with sulfur, you can have a problem with detoxification, and it can make you feel quite sick. So how do you get around this? What are we going to do about all this? What's the solution? Well, you can't really completely avoid sulfur. It's very hard to get it out of your diet. There are a couple of reasons why sulfur could be playing up with you. So let me just go back to my notes here. So what you could be looking at, for example, is a genetic mutation. Some people have this. We know that, for example, with B12, you know, we've got the MTHFR gene. So you can be a homozygous or like have two bad copies of a gene. And that can cause a problem called CBS or cystathione beta synthase. You can actually do an online search for CBS to see if you've got a problem with this particular pathway. And then if you have, you can do that test, I believe, online. And that will allow you then to make up your mind if you want to avoid the highest sulfur-containing foods or not, which is probably not a bad idea. But one of the most common ways people get a sulfur sensitivity is through heavy metal toxicity. So if we look at the four main metals that affect people if they've got a sulfur problem, are lead, arsenic, cadmium, and mercury. These are sulfhydryl metals. So these metals in particular can make some people, you know, really sick if they've got a buildup of them due to the sulfur sensitivity. You could do a hair analysis to determine, you know, what your level of heavy metals are like in the body. And particularly mercury can be a really big problem if you've got a sensitivity towards sulfur. So that's something that you might want to have a look at. One way you can test if you've got a big sulfur problem is through the organic acids test, so the OAT test. You know, that's a urinary metabolite test. That will give you an idea. And the markers you're going to find that could come back could be high sulfates, ammonia, orotate, citrate, isocitrate, or vitamin B6. These could be really affected if you've got a sulfur problem. So, and I mentioned about the genetic tests, you can do those. So what do you do if you've got a sulfur sensitivity? How do you get this fixed up? Well, go to Google and then do a Google search for the list of the highest sulfur-containing foods and then try and eliminate some of those from your diet to see if it does really make a difference. If it does, and that's the only thing that you've done, you can put some of the highest sulfur-containing foods back in to see if you get aggravated and feel sick again. So let's look at some of the symptoms here. Itchiness, hives, asthma, headache, nausea, fatigue, flushing, brain fog. These are all particular symptoms that can happen with sulfur sensitivity. So how do you eliminate sulfur from your body if it builds up too much? Well, the last step in sulfur detoxification is an enzyme system called sulfite oxidase. So if you take a trace element called molybdenum, it helps that enzyme system work effectively, and that allows you to excrete more sulfur from the body. The other thing you can do is take chlorophyll drinks or green sort of alkalizing detoxifying drinks. And you know, these could, there are so many of them out there, the green drinks. You probably know some of these, for example, what are some of them, like green barley grass, spirulina. And you can get a liquid chlorophyll drink on its own. You can also eat the deep leafy greens like spinach, for example, might be a good one to help you, but also chard and collards and kale. So these are drinks you could make up just to pour that chlorophyll into the body to help cleanse the system. But the thing I recommend you do is to do a heavy metal analysis. All right, so do a hair test through either Doctor's Data or Genova Diagnostics and have a look if you've got any of those four metals, cadmium, arsenic, mercury or lead, particularly mercury. If these are elevated, you may want to get onto that and remove those from the body to a high extent, because that will allow sulfur to work more effectively in the body and stop clashing with these heavy metals. And but give it a try, it might be worth it. So you may not have a histamine sensitivity after all, you may have a sulfur sensitivity. So I hope that answers a few questions. Thanks for tuning in.